We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to the variant of this track back in 1978, and it was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. If you want flat-out racing, you've come to the right place this weekend, as it's full throttle for 59% of this 2.7-mile circuit, peaking at around 210 miles per hour going into the final chicane. But that speed requires discipline, and there are more than a few close walls here just waiting to punish drivers with a heavy right foot. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. What a qualifying yesterday for George Russell. He'll start today's race from pole position, and Jenson Button completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Verstappen, Hamilton, Norris, Leclerc, Clark, Tsunoda, Fernando Alonso, Stroll, Perez, Joe, Albon, Bottas, Oscar Piastri, Ocon, Magnussen, Hülkenberg, Gasly, De Vries, and Logan Sargeant. With preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. And with me today, of course, is Natalie Pinkham. Let's talk about Clark. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within the team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do. And that has definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
He was caught speeding in the pit lane in practice for the 2006 Turkish.
The formation lap gets underway, and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for the battle once the lights go out. Start the race as the cars take their positions on the grid, with the drivers and teams making their final preparations.
Okay, now stay alert for threats around you. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done. Car behind is dropping back by about 3/10 a lap. Well done. Overtake button more. It's time to utilize some of this energy. Come on. trailing our teammate by 7.6 seconds. Slowly gaining on the car in front, try to keep up this momentum. Okay, we're approaching the pit window. You're going to be on softs. Okay, we're boxing this lap. Give us the best in lap you can. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. Okay, push, push. Gap to the car behind. 2.1 seconds. Teammate ahead is 13.0 seconds. Job. Verstappen has the lead. here's some information on Russell for you. Okay, they're out of this race. Catching the car ahead, well done, but be aware, these tyres need to get us to the end of this race. Caution, caution! Okay, clear. Our gap to the car in front is 2.1 seconds. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. On him, he might make a mistake. We're currently trailing our teammate by 16.0 seconds. Verstappen's out in front. like we've got enough fuel for three more laps. Okay, gap ahead is 4.0 seconds. Okay, mate, final lap. Keep your concentration and let's bring it home. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
A nearly flawless performance here then, and a commanding victory. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
Quite simply, a driver is nothing without the team behind them. So, a deserved winner, but we do have to give a shout out to the team in the pit lane and back at the factory. Very much a collaborative process.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. Let's focus on the driver of the day. Natalie Pinkham, come on, who do you pick?
Well, often my go-to would be a driver who's managed to pull off an impressive feat during the race. However, in this instance, I was more impressed by Jenson Button's clean driving throughout the event.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One, so be sure to join us for the next one.